Hello everyone, welcome back to Steve on Steve Plays Ostalgie, the Berlin Wall. So, my first series ended quite poorly after only two episodes, but that's because I had no idea how this game worked, I'd only just picked it up. But now, after a few hours of confidently playing this game, I am fairly confident that I understand its mechanics, and I even managed to finish it once. Which made me very proud, and hopefully I'll be able to show you guys how to do it. And yeah, hopefully this will be interesting, because this game is in many ways better than Crisis in the Kremlin. It's a lot more in-depth in certain areas, the events are more interesting, I think, in some places. It's just very interesting. What else is there to say? So yeah, let's get right into it. So yes, we will again be playing as the GDR, because that's the one I've been playing around with, and I think I more or less figured out how to do it. So yes, we'll be putting party doggery, Western propaganda, and pressure from Moscow. And let's get immediately into it. So, I figured several things out. Basically, if you want to survive past 1990, you need to have 30 money in your reserve. I think the music is a bit too loud. Oh well, it'll have to do. This is as low as it gets. Anyway, so yes, we need to have 30 money in our reserve because the Soviets will abandon the Comecon, the Council, the CMEA, this economical union that we have, and we can either, you know, let it collapse, which will destroy the economies of the Warsaw Pact countries, or we can try to reform our own with some other countries, which is the best way to go around doing it. Yeah, so straight off the bat, let's pick some science. We'll go with security, re-equipment of special services, just so that he'll help fight Ostalgie and give us more agents. Yeah, agents are quite important, and we're going to want to build a building at some point to increase their amount. Yes, let's spend some money on building research institutes. I'm going to build two of them. And that greatly speeds up our science. That's important because we want to get through this tree as fast as possible, because it gives some really good bonuses, especially the last ones. In terms of starting off things, we start with 90 diplomatic reputation, which is conservative. It's not as bad as authoritarian, but it does mean we can't trade with China or Syria, which is what we want to do. So one of the events that will be popping up here will be an event that allows us to decrease that by 1 or 2 points, and we're going to want to do that, so we can start trading with Syria and China. So, one of the things we can do immediately is do the Lebanon, recognize Syria and Lebanon, and break off relations with Israeli one. That pops us down to 89, which is really nice. And also very important is to keep the social camp stability relatively high, preferably above 95 is ideal. And basically the lower that is, the more, you know, unstable this Warsaw Pact countries will become and start falling apart, etc. And we obviously don't want that to happen, because we'll be trying to preserve socialism even if Gorbachev and the USSR abandons it. Now, yes, we'll wait for... Let's unpause briefly. Alright, so this is the first event. In the Soviet Union, the film Integral was released. This event would have gone unnoticed. Basically, this is like a bit of liberalization, and we're gonna say that, yeah, we'll do it. And, yeah, this gives us 88 diplomatic reputation, which means we can now trade... it has to be less than 88. So there's gonna be an event of chemical peace treaty in France, and hopefully that will bump us down a bit as well. What's this? Combat groups of the working class. So far, I've been unable to understand what this event does. I mean, I always press this, and that seems to work. It lowers Ostalgie a bit, which is nice. So yeah, let's wait for that France event for a few... There it is. Fight against chemical weapons. Yep, we will sign it. And that lowers our diplomatic reputation even a little bit more. And now we can trade with Syria. We can establish relationships with China. And we can trade with China. We need to watch out our money, because one of the ways to very quickly lose in this game is to let your reserves go negative and have to, budget cuts, because those destroy party unity and support and standard of living as well. So, now that we are established, we can actually now start doing events that... Not events, but making decisions that will push diplomatic reputation back up. But it doesn't really matter from this point. Although whilst we're still here, we might want to fund the JCP. Establish connection with communists. We don't spend any money on that, and it makes the socialist camp a bit stronger, and it leads to further events later on. So we'll do it. Yes, now, we'll make a contract with India, because that means later we'll be able to provoke the Indo-Pakistan war, and that prevents India from liberalizing, and it makes the Warsaw camp stronger, and it makes the war in Afghanistan end quicker, theoretically. And it also gives us this asylum option later for boosting party unity if it drops significantly. Okay, that's good. Let's see how many agents we have. We're going to want to save up agents for at least the first month, because there's going to be an event in Vietnam which we're going to want to influence. Let's see, let's support Gaddafi in Libya. That's cost us one money, so we can't spend any more. This allows us to start trade with him and channel oil, which should improve our economy. And I think we can send military support to Afghanistan. Yep, that increases socialist camp stability, but that decreases our agents and it increases our diplomatic reputation. So yeah, let's unpause. Let's go speed 2. Yep, everything's fine. Ostalgie is slowly increasing at the beginning of the game, but it's nothing to worry about. It's really low, and it's going up very slowly, so we're fine. Let's speed it up a bit more. No events yet, that's pretty strange, but okay. So we basically want to avoid spending money, if at all possible, in this first year. After that we're going to get a very steady income, and we should be fine. But yes, let's see, our agents are growing at a very steady pace, that's great. When is this event going to fire in Vietnam? I want to start using my agents on supporting my Warsaw Pact comrades. Alright, there we go. So, the disease of the Vietnamese reform, the Vietnamese Gorbachev is unwell, and there we go, we can support a conservative party coup. So Vietnam will now stay red, which will help later. And this event in Germany. Yeah, somebody in one of my comments pointed out that this is the formation of the group Rammstein. But I don't want to spend money, so we will deny them support. This increases Ostalgie by 1 point, but it's still very insignificant. So now that event in Vietnam has occurred, how many agents do we have? 5. Ooh, that's... There's 5 countries in the Warsaw Pact. So yes, we do this. Coordination and finance, those two things help them stay in the socialist system, which we obviously want them to do, because we're going to want to keep them in our economic alliance later. So we give them coordination, give Czechoslovakia coordination, Hungary, Romania. Ah, we ran out of agents. I thought it took 1 agent, but it turns out it takes 2. All the better. Hopefully we'll be able to use those 2 agents on Bulgaria and Romania, and then we'll provoke the war with Pakistan. Let's see, there's also Albania. We can support the Ramiz Alia regime, which doesn't cost us anything. And we can later restore relations with them, which means we can then trade, which is great, because you want to have as many trade partners as you can in this game, because, well, you know, it's money. We finished our first science, which is great. That will help fight Ostalgie. Let's go with genetics, because we'll later get an event which kickstarts our automation research, so it's better to start off researching something else, from my experience. Let's see, our agents, only 1 still, although we can still do it. Oh well, whatever, I don't know how it works. And we'll do it in Bulgaria as soon as possible. Aha, something is happening in Burma. State Peace and Development Council. News of a coup d'etat in the Socialist Republic of the Union of Burma, for the common people also known as Burma. So, let's see, what can we do? We can send them congratulations, and this established for the first time diplomatic relations. That could be good. I think that starts immediate trade with them, which is useful. However, it is possible in this situation we should continue to adhere to the Moscow line. No, we are going to break away from Moscow because we don't care. Also, our general staff is proposing a project to expand our sphere of influence and protect the revolution from the capitalist threat. Ooh, our agents too weak, yep, unfortunately. So yeah, we'll send ambassadors with congratulations, because now we have the close trade, which basically means we're trading with them, which is great, because that's, you know, extra development and income, etc. Let's see how our agents are. Still tiny, we still can't support them in Bulgaria yet. We'll wait a bit. Money is going up steadily, which is good. We want to make sure that by January 1990 we have at least 30 in the reserve. Which does limit your spending in the early game, but it's really not that important. Let's see, can we do it now? The music in this game is fantastic, by the way. They've done a great job, like in the first game, of collecting some relatively obscure pieces of music from the socialist era, which is awesome. So, military and special services assistant to Bulgaria. So now hopefully this will help them stay on the socialist path. Okay, China. Tiananmen Square. Now, we can condemn them, which lowers our diplomatic reputation and makes Gorbachev like us and the West like us. But that breaks our trade relations and will cost a lot to restore them. So we're going to speak in defense of the Chinese government, which helps the camp stability. And it lets us retain trade with China, which is great. So, we can sell some licenses to Korea. That gives us a nice boost of money. Send them analysts as well. I'm not sure what that does. I honestly don't know. I so far have not been able to understand what kind of impact that has on the game. Oh, I suppose the only purpose it has is to make it more friendly to you, that you can invite them into the union later. But other than that, I don't think it has any kind of gameplay ramifications, as far as I can tell. So we really don't want to spend our money, so after 1990 we'll start sending aid and all that kind of stuff, but for now we really can't afford to. We'll put sanctions on Pakistan. Let's see how many agents we have. Soon we'll be able to provoke the Kashmir War, or the second Kashmir War, or whatever. Ooh, okay, two events. Japan. Red Rising Sun. So this, we don't have. So here we can either support them financially, which I don't think will be enough. We don't have any agents, unfortunately. We don't have enough agents to make like a full-blown like counter-movement in Japan. But one annoying thing in this game is you don't know how much money you're spending. It's kind of, you have to like trial and error, really. Alright, three. That's not okay. Not the best result. Kind of a waste, really, but that's okay. We still have a few months to recover that. Let's see what's happening in Moscow. Helmut Kohl discovered. This is basically Gorbachev wants us to be friendly with West Germany, and we won't do that, of course. So yeah, we'll unpause for a bit, and look at that, it's almost the end of 1989. Ostalgie is low, support of the people is high, party support is high, standard of living is relatively high, keeps rising. We've got a bunch of money, not as much as I'd like to yet. Socialist camp stability is 97.7, which is great. I mean, everything is going pretty much as good as it can. Except for the Japan one, I was hoping that would have gone better, but I did not foresee that we were going to need our agents at that point. Yeah, this game forces you to allocate resources in the right places, you know, have to prioritize. Alright, let's see. So, these two events are important. So, basically what happens is that there's the Shah, or not the Shah, the Ayatollah of Iran dies. And we can either, you know, just say, well, you know, we're sorry, people die, it's an unfortunate thing. Or we can, like, fully, like, go there and bring our condolences and shit. But the problem with that is Honecker, who's old conservative, can't do that. The party won't allow him. And this event, time has come, allows us to replace Honecker with several different kinds of people. So let me read that out for you. Honecker was forced to interrupt his participation in the meeting on the evening he was taken to the Romanian government clinic with biliary colic. After the preliminary stabilization of the health of Honecker, surgery was carried out to remove the inflamed gallbladder and a part of the large intestine. According to urologist Peter Althaus, during the operation it was found, but due to the patient's poor condition, the supposedly cancers were not removed in the right kidney, which Honecker was not informed about. Due to this condition, until about September of this year, he won't be able to personally perform his duties. And we can replace him. So, we can have Egon Krenz, who is a liberal, which is, we don't want that. There's Erich Milke, who's a hardcore kind of Stalinist, which, you know, we might take him. And there's some other useless people. So yeah, you can either take Milke, which will allow us to trade with Iran, which is nice. Or we can take Honecker, which is stability. I kind of want to remain with Honecker because, you know, I really like Honecker, like as a politician, like historically, and his theories and his ideas and everything. I think he was a good leader. But also, you know, we're not exactly role-playing with all the things that we're doing. But also, there's an achievement for keeping Honecker until the end of the game, and I want to get that. So the one time that I did play this through to the very end, there was a choice in 1992 to end the game and get a bunch of achievements, or to just keep playing and see what happens, but you don't get achievements. And I did that, because I wanted to, you know, to be recorded when I get some achievements, just because I think it's interesting. So yeah, well, stability. We'll keep Honecker. Yeah, nothing much changes. Honecker returned to Berlin. He did not fulfill his duties for several months, but that's okay. He'll be fine. So now, the Iran, we can't fly personally. Yeah. So, yeah, we'll send our condolences, nothing much. So, this will make it very difficult to have any kind of relationship with Iran until a much later time. Or not at all, really. What's up in Germany again? There we go, this is the event that I was referring to that lets us automatically start researching automation. Wow, that was a terrible sentence. Yes, we will. It's time to announce a course on automation. That pisses off the party quite a lot. So we will use our asylum, which is great. That makes them really happy. So now, as we can see, this will soon be finished, and this already has a bit of a kickstart in research, which is really nice. Yep, let's pause for a little bit. Yeah, everything is going fine. We're stable. I'm gonna end this episode soon, and hopefully next episode we'll see our new economic union being built from the ashes of Comic-Con. Ooh, something else in here. Release the house. Situation in the country is heating up. We need to do something. Yeah, this is the second attempt to replace Honecker. You get two chances to replace him if you want to. But no, he will remain. That increases Ostalgie by quite a bit, which is unfortunate. Yeah. But we'll be faithful to our buddy Honecker. We'll keep him in power. So if by the end of December we have over 30, I'll send aid to Afghanistan. But I don't want to spend any money until I can be sure that I'll afford it. So let's see this. What's this? Operation Valkyrie. This is about the attempt to assassinate Hitler in 1944. We will not praise Nazis, because why would we? But yeah, I think this is going to be it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like, subscribe, and leave any comments in the comments below. Any suggestions, any questions about the game, I'll be happy to accept or try to answer to the best of my abilities. Really loving this game, I hope you guys are too. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.